gets it ahead. Brought back on, but not yet controlled by Shepard. Over to Straka, and Shepard has scored!
This is the Avalanche's first look at the Rats. My goodness.
Well, this is the heaviest.
Oh.
They added more staff for this game tonight. 25 people are out there gathering them in. The strangest thing they said they've picked up in these playoffs has been a box of Decon, which is a rat killer. They actually did have, as you will have with any spontaneous thing, somebody who actually turned loose a real one out there, and they very carefully got it coaxed into one of the buckets that they use.
Chin battles it past Stapleton. The Leafs get it up on the wing. Kessel ran into Hainsey, but is able to get to the loose puck. Now carries in over the line, and Hainsey reached around him, and it is shot in wide of the goal, and...
Waffles.
And some fan has decided to throw something on the ice, and it'll be scooped up.
An idiot, and he's being ushered out of here. I mean, that was right in mid-play.
Somebody could have slipped on that.
Yeah.
The Waffles are on the ice again, whatever that means.
I haven't figured that out either, but... And, fan being escorted out. And the faceoff to the left.
Two best scoring chances for Nashville here in the third period.
Uh-oh, and Thrasher jerseys being thrown onto the ice. Look at that.
What is that?
Thrasher's jerseys thrown on the ice.
I have no idea what that is.
Is that in tribute to their old team, or?
I hope it is. I hope we take it as a compliment, because haven't played the game for a lot of years. The one thing you don't allow is disrespect to your jersey, man. That's Pat Quinn when they were running over his jersey, and he went ballistic when he was a coach.
Yeah.
He didn't allow it by anybody.
Well, he's got to go play the Rangers. Yeah. How much meaning is that going to? Is that game going to? Just 2 points separated the Rangers and the Islanders coming into tonight. You know, they play against each other. The Islanders have an extra game. It's interesting.
Yeah. Yeah. Well, from a Bruins perspective, it'd be good if the Rangers were pretty mad. Did somebody throw an octopus on the ice? Detroit does travel well.
To have a shift like that and have a game the way they've played, and you know, and not to overlook something too, Jack, as we really enjoy the complete game effort right now as we get some more squid on the ice.
Calamari, baby.
A guy like Max Talbot.
Yeah.
You know, he comes up and okay, it's an emergency. You know, you got to have injury for him to be in the lineup. But the fact that he went down with the right attitude in Providence, a guy that's played in big game situations, a veteran guy, you know, he didn't go down to Providence and get out of shape. He kept himself in great shape, worked hard. His numbers were good down there.
It's Henrik Sedin off the ice, and someone has thrown a fish on the ice.
Here his opportunity. Not for that fish. Second best power play at home. Almost 24%.
With a minute 46 to go in OT.
Oh, the smoke bomb.
Is that what it was?
Yeah.
Okay, I saw something hurled out of the seats, and it had a light at the end of it, but I didn't realize that's what it was.
Oh, yeah, right. I saw that flash through as well. Thought it was a falling star, and then I realized this isn't an outdoor game.
I should remember from my Halloween days, but I had forgotten clearly.
You know, Doc, it was right down below us that I saw the smoke bomb or being thrown. So they're trying to locate the crazy individual who just did that. We may have a replay. Watch here. We've got a replay. Watch in the whole area here. It's going to come flying. Let's keep watching. Same area. Oh, there's the smoke. There's the smoke after it landed. But I saw, as you did, Doc, I saw it traveling through the air. And it had a flame behind it. And I couldn't figure out at the time what it was. And now we know.
Quite the repertoire. And a lot of variation. Sagan with speed this time. In on Hedberg. Closes and scores.
even despite the debris thrown onto the ice when Sagan was charging towards Hedberg.
Which is inexcusable.
And I think the Devils are going to try to bring attention to it.
Yeah, why not? Why not?
But as far as the move by Sagan, attack with speed, come from the off-wing side, move backhand to forehand, get the goaltender moving. Hedberg tries to take away the lower half of the net, which he did. Sagan wisely goes up top.
Mark Jonette coming over to talk to Claude Julien. Now, we know that all goals are reviewable. Can they review video of this to see if the debris might have been in the field of vision or not?
I don't think Hedberg ever saw it.
I don't think so either.
Came from the stands, went in behind him.
Well, some lunkhead has put the Bruins shootout lead in jeopardy. Sagan on his second chance scores! Well, how do you do?
And why not change it up a little bit? This time Sagan comes from the opposite direction. He's going to favor the forehand side. But the speed was the same. He attacks the net.